Okay, everyone, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today we I will continue our lesson about expressing compliment. But today we will study about grammar in this chapter. So what kind of grammar that we will study? First is simple present tense and then simple past tense. Okay, so everyone please listen to me and then look at the video properly. Don't forget to write down any questions or if you want to ask me, you can text me or by WhatsApp or comment below, okay? Okay, now we will study about simple present tense. I think you have already studied about this when you were in junior high school, right? So I just want to review about this simple present tense. So simple present tense is used to first talk about facts that are generally true or stay true for a long time. For example, you are the best friend that anyone could ever ask for. So it means the best friend here is really true about or facts about your friend. Maybe since you were in junior high school, or I mean from elementary school until junior high school. So you said that your friend are the best, okay? For example, facts are generally true. We want to talk about sun rises in the east, right? And then sunset in the west. So this is true or generally or fact. Okay, next, describe feelings and sense. So the second purpose or goals of simple present tense is describe feelings and sense. For example, I'm very grateful, I'm happy, I'm full, and then I'm sad, something like that. So we can say it by using simple present tense. Okay, next. So what is the formula of simple present tense? If the subject is singular, we can use subject I plus to be if there is no verb. Yeah, so this is the rule for non-verb. Yeah, for example, I'm very grateful. And then the second formula is a verb. Yeah, using verb. For example, subject I plus verb. Verb 1, for example, I love you. Okay, next, singular you plus are if we use adjective. For example, you are the best friend. The best friend is, the best is adjective, and also grateful is adjective. That's why we use to be. Okay, next, if we use it, he or she, we will use to be is. For example, there is someone. So this is the formula of non-verb. It means there is no verb in the sentence. Okay, we use only for adjective or noun and also adverb. Okay, then the next example, it, he, she. The subject, it, he, she plus verb 1. We also add S or ES in the end of the verb 1. Okay, for example, someone who thinks about you. Someone, it means we can replace he or she, right? So the verb is thinks, not think. Use or we add S in the end of this verb. Okay, so that's why the formula verb S plus S or ES. Okay, next, plural subject, we use they or we. If the example use verb, we can make the subject the formula they plus verb 1. So they or we plus verb 1. They care or we care. Okay, if there is no verb or we can use non-verb, they or we plus to be are. Are plus adjective, noun or adverb. For example, they are happy. Okay, we can use they and then add to be are and then plus adjective happy. Happy is adjective. Okay, next we come to the next tense explanation, verbs in simple present tense. So if the letter es is added after a sound spells s, z, ch, sh and x, so we will use es in the end of the verb. For example, pass become passes, bus buzzes, catch cates, push pushed, miss mix mixes. And then a word with y preceded by a consonant, we change into I and then we add es. I mean, for example, carry. Carry in the end of the word is y, right? Carry, c a r r y. So the y we change into or to be I, so become carries. And then don't forget to add es in the end of the word. Carry become carries, or like try, try become tries. Okay, so this is the rule for verb 1 for using verb in present tense. If you use subject it, he, she, so only for subject he, she, it or it, he, she. Okay, grammar in action, we use simple past tense. So use the simple past tense for actions that took place in the past. After y preceded by a consonant, the y is changed to I and plus ed is added, carried and tried. This is for past tense. And after a single consonant preceded by a single stretched vowel, the final consonant is double before ed. For example, stop is spelling stop, right? Because we use past tense, and then P we make it double, stopped, and then plus ed, and then also permitted. The verb one is permit, P E R M I T, because of we change into past tense, become permitted double T plus ed. After final or the last word is e, we only use or add d. Yeah, so is d is added. For example, change in verb 1 only change c h a n g e, right? And then we only add d, become change. And then argue in the end of the word is using e, so we just add d. Okay, so this is the function or and also the rules of verb in simple past tense. I repeat again, so we use simple past tense for action that took place in the past. It means the action that took place in the past, but we know about the time. Is the formula of simple past tense. If the subject is singular, for example, I, and then non-verb, so we use to be was. For example, I was in your house yesterday. Because there is no verb, we use to be was. Okay, next. If there is verb in your sentence, we use I plus verb 2. For example, I played the game last night. So verb 2 is play. Play, we add ed in the end of the word, okay? And then next, you. If the sentence is non-verb, we use to be were. For example, you were in my house last week. In my house also adverb. Next, you plus verb 2. For example, you bought a bag yesterday. So there is a verb bought here, the verb 2 of buy. And then, for example, of singular subject, it, he, she, we can add was, be was as non-verb. Yeah, if your sentence there is no verb or we call it non-verb, we use was as a to be. For example, she was in her room last night. So her room is adverb. Okay, and then it, he, she plus verb 2 if you use verb in your sentence. For example, he wrote a letter last month. Okay, so wrote is verb 2 of write. Okay, I think that's all for singular. And then we come to the plural subject. So plural subject are they and we. So we can put where, yeah, where, for example, they were happy in my house yesterday. It is for non-verb. If there is verb, so the formula is they plus we plus verb 2. For example, we cooked some pizza last week. Okay, cook here is plus ed. Okay, next, grammar in action. So the simple past tense rule is the regular verb. So there are two kind of verb in past tense. First is regular and then second is irregular verb. So what are regular verbs? So the rule is, like I told you before, add d to the verb. For example, received become received, dream become dream. For example, I never received such a letter. So ed is, if we add ed or d in the end of the word, it means regular verb. But irregular verbs is, the rule is different. So it will be changed. For example, is become was, are become were, am become was, read become read. So the written is same, but the sound is different. Read verb 1, read verb 2. And then has or have become had. For example, my mother was like the finest of Indonesian tea. So was like here come from to be is. Okay, and also another example, read red and then cut. Okay, cut verb 1, cut verb 2. So this is irregular verb. And then hit verb 1, hit verb 2, and also become irregular verbs in simple past tense. Okay, I think that's all my explanation about simple present and simple past tense, because you have already known about two kind of tenses that I taught before in junior high school. Okay, I think that's all. If there is no if there is a question, you can text me by WhatsApp or comment column below of my YouTube. Okay, thank you. That's all. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye.